The objective of this video is to provide you with the general recommendations on how to use the Dräger Perseus A500 anesthesia device for long-term ventilation. Medical staff should be instructed in the use of the medical equipment and should be familiarized with the functionalities of the Dräger anesthesia devices. Make sure an experienced anesthesia colleague is always available, like for example an anesthesiologist, 24/7. The recommendation is, in the case of any problem, call for help in an early stage. Before starting the case and connecting the patient to the system, verify the readiness of the device and the accessories. We will cover further details in following videos. An external resuscitator must always be available at the workplace. This is to secure ventilation of the patient in case of failure of the system. For non-invasive ventilation, ICU mechanical ventilator or non-invasive ventilator should be preferred. All vaporizers should be removed from the anesthesia device. The smallest amount of anesthetic agent might trigger malignant hyperthermia on the patient or on the clinical staff. To remove the vaporizer, press the button and move the dial to the T for transport position. Then, turn the lever. Be aware that the vaporizer is quite heavy. Make sure nitrous oxide is not supplied to the anesthesia device. Disconnect the hose from the source first, and then from the back of the device. Be aware the manual spontaneous mode in the ICU mechanical ventilator is not the same as in the anesthesia device. Please use the mode only after being instructed. When using the anesthesia device for long-term ventilation, it is not recommended to use the external fresh gas outlet if available, neither the pulse mode. Keep in mind that when using volume control ventilation modes, automatic compensation of the leakage will not be in place. So, pressure control ventilation modes are always preferred. In the case of fresh gas flow deficit or a big leakage, you will also notice that the manual breathing bag gets emptied. You should act immediately. To secure mechanical ventilation of the patient, you can follow the next steps. Identify and correct the leakages. Increase the fresh gas flow. Additionally, you can detach the manual breathing bag from the system. This will allow ambient air to enter the system. In this case, be aware that the inspired fraction of oxygen will be between the set percentage of oxygen in the fresh gas flow and 21% oxygen from the ambient air. Our recommendation is that the user should always be in the vicinity of the anesthesia device. Keep in mind that the design of the alarm management has been done so for the operating theater. We recommend also to set the alarm volume to the maximum level. To do so, you press the alarm button, then go to the settings, and you increase the volume to the maximum using the rotary knob. Don't forget to confirm using the rotary knob. Be aware that the anesthesia device will automatically delete the alarm messages on the display once the event triggering the alarm has disappeared. To verify on the alarms that might have occurred in the absence of the user, first go to the Trends and Data button, and then go to the Logbook tab. When using the anesthesia device for long-term ventilation, you have to regularly check on all the accessories on it. You will have to visually inspect the condition of the soda lime and also the inspiratory level of CO2. You have to check on the gas measurement water trap. You have to check on the breathing hose system and the patient filter. To verify on the condition of the soda lime, you will have to visually inspect that no more than 2/3 of its content has turned into color purple. Additionally, you will have to verify that the inspired level of CO2, it is not higher than 5 millimeters of mercury. The procedure to exchange the soda lime canister when you have the click system in place is to get a new cartridge available. Then you press the release button and you slide the canister out. Slide the new canister in and lock it. In the case you have a reusable cartridge, please get instructed by an experienced anesthesia colleague. Another important element to verify is the gas measurement water trap. To do so, make sure that no more than 50% of its capacity it is filled with water. To drain the water trap, you will need a regular syringe. You first deattach the sample line. And you take the water trap out. You will place the syringe in the lower port, the one colored, and you drain it. In the case there are more water in the trap, you might have to repeat the procedure. Once the trap is empty, you put it back on the port. And you place back the sample line. Additionally, you have to verify the condensed level of water in the breathing hose system. The recommendation is to use a breathing hose system that has a water trap. To drain it, just turn the water trap and directly drain it. Then put it back on its place. Keep in mind the recommendation when using an anesthesia device is always to use a mechanical filter. When using the device for long-term ventilation, you should use a mechanical filter with HME. That is to improve the passive humidification of the system and place the filter on the system the closest possible to the patient. Hospital guidelines for infection prevention and control should always be followed. Always check the tightly connection of the sample line. This should be attached to the gas measurement water trap and to the patient filter. All gas measurements are done through this system. You have to constantly visually monitor the values of the FiO2 and CO2. Because of the rebreathing system, the measured values might differ slightly from the set ones. Keep in mind that the manual breathing bag will be fully and evenly filled. You will also notice that it will move in synchronization to the mechanical ventilation. Remember that drug nebulization and aerosol therapy are not suitable for the anesthesia device. The anesthesia device should always be verified every 24 hours, but when used for long-term ventilation, our recommendation is doing it always every 72 hours. The detailed procedure on how to perform the self-test on the Perseus A500 will be provided in a separate video.